الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد: أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم، كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المؤمنين وبشر المحسنين. اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العليم الحكيم. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما نافعا. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي: يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. صلى الله على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. My dear respected brothers and elders, it is a great opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has enabled me and you to sit here. And I ask Allah to inspire me words that becomes the means and the reasons for the deliverance in the day of Qiyamah from the fire of Jahannam.
Amen.
This auspicious moment, this most important time in the Islamic calendar, it plays a great role in the Islamic history. And not just this, at this moment, at this defining moment, all the Hujjaj Ikram are on one platform with one intention, doing the same thing in the same manner, in the same posture, going in Mina and praising and doing the talbiyah and saying labbaik allahumma labbaik labbaik la sharika lak labbaik innal hamda wan ni'mata lak wal mulk la sharika lak. How fortunate is those people who today is going to Hajj, and what is our responsibility, what is our responsibility as we have not been to Hajj? And may Allah, who has not been to Hajj, make us make our intention this year that we will go to Hajj next year.
Amen.
If you make your Hajj niyyah from today, and before coming to next year, you die, Allah will raise you as a Hajj. Allah will raise you as a Hajj. So make your intention every year. You don't know when you're going to die, but if you die, then inshallah is granted. So what is our responsibility as a ghair haji who has not been to Hajj? We have to copy and become similar like the Hujjaj Ikram. The scholars have written, and it's in the hadith of Ibn Majah, that this is in the stage of mustahab, desirable, that those people who is not going to Hajj, he should not cut his nails, cut his hair, become similar like the Hujjaj Ikram as soon as the first of Dhul Hajjah. As soon as the first of Dhul Hajjah. This is our responsibility. But this is desirable. You see, Allah looks at us. Allah likes us imitating. And what can be the best of imitating Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We are imitating Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the best imitation for a person to imitate is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today, it has become a common trend. People are making role models on many different things, but they are forgetting about the greatest being, the best of model, the best of teachings, the pure teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So I'm not coming to that yet, but I'm talking about Hajj. So we need to come and imitate the Hujjaj Ikram. This is our responsibility. These 10 days of Hajj, which is Allah has took oath and qasam in Surah Al-Fajr. Allah says, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ وَالشَّفِعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. Allah takes oath of the Fajr and the 10 nights and the odd and the eve. Allah, majority of the scholars have written that the 10 nights Allah is talking about is the 10 nights of Hajj. It comes in the riwayat, the narration of Ibn Majah, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that fasting one day of Dhul Hajjah, from the first till the ninth of Dhul Hajjah, fasting one day from the first till the ninth of Dhul Hajjah, one day is equivalent of fasting a whole year. And every night is equivalent in reward of Laylatul Qadr. So you can imagine the times, the moment, Allah increases the value of that time. It is all in the hands of Allah. It is not in me and your hand. The value of the time, the reward of the time to increase, it is in the hands of Allah. That's why we submit to Allah. You know what is the greatest? You know what is the core teachings of Islam? Submission to Allah's command and hukum. This is the core, and this is what they cannot understand. This is what they cannot understand. That how is these Muslims, all together in millions, they're going to Hajj, doing all these rituals and doing the Hajj and all the acts of deeds of Hajj. How are they doing all this? Because the Muslim only understands one thing, submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the fazila, the virtue of Hajj, of the days of Hajj. But fasting the first 8 days until the day of Arafah, it is desirable. It is desirable. But on the day of Arafah, it is more recommended because the hadith is more stronger. Because the hadith is more stronger. That's why on the day of Arafah, what is the virtue? أَنْ يُكَفِّرَ السَّنَةَ الَّذِي قَبْلَهُ أَوْ بَعْدَهُ. That a person who fasts on the day of Arafah, Allah Ta'ala is forgiving his previous year of sin and future. Now some people take to the misunderstanding, and there is people around, that they think, or they may think, that Allah has forgiven my past and future, which means I've got a certificate, what I can do. This is not the meaning. Every good deeds in Islam, if you have Iman, every good deeds in Islam, if you have Iman, it is expiating and removing your sins. It can be in the form of charity, it can be in the form of salah, it can be in the form of being obedient, it can be in the form of coming to the house of Allah, it can be in the form of helping someone. In many ways, I can just carry on. In many forms, it is expiating and removing your sins. But these sins are the minor sins. The major sins, they must be tawbah and firm conviction that you will not commit this sin anymore in the future. So these, the hadith that is given, the glad tidings, are the minor sins. And on this day, on the day of Arafah, it is a great day. It is a great day. Now before coming to the day of Arafah, it is mustahab, as we know, from the ninth of Dhul Hajjah. From the ninth of Dhul Hajjah, which is the day of Arafah, we have to do takbir after every salah until the 13th of Dhul Hajjah, till Asr. Till Asr on the 13th of Dhul Hajjah. But before the ninth, in your mind, it is more desirable that you read takbir and tahleel The ulamas and the scholars have recommended, and it comes in a hadith, that as soon as the first of Zilhajjah comes in, you should start reading takbir. You should start reading takbir slowly in your mind. Slowly in your mind. But the wajib takbir, which is from the ninth of Dhul-Hajjah, it is wajib upon every male. And according to the, for the females, there's a two opinion. There's two opinions. One, it says it's not wajib for the females. But another one, it says, yes, it is wajib. So it is more stronger that you make your women's. You make your women's to read the takbir after every salah. And on these days, after the ninth of Dhul-Hajjah, it is called Ayyam al-Tashriq. And in the day of Ayyam al-Tashriq, مَلَا تَصُومُ فِي هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ فَإِنَّهُ مِنْ أَكْلٍ وَشُرْبٍ وَبِعَالٍ 5 days, it is ممنوع. It is haram to fast throughout the whole year. And you can fast throughout the whole year. The 3 days of Ayyam al-Tashriq and the 2 Eids. The 2 Eids and the 3 days of Ayyam al-Tashriq. It is ممنوع, haram for you to fast. So now, on the day of Arafah, people who will be fasting, please fast. And make a lot of dua on this day. Make a lot of dua. The next day, which is the day of Eid, this day there is 2 things. Number one is that the Hajjis will be doing the acts of Hajj. And those people who have not gone to Hajj, they will be doing Qurbani. And Qurbani is only first wajib. The Qurbani is only wajib upon the muqeem, not the musafir, not the traveler. The person who is traveling, for him there is no Qurbani. And who is Qurbani farz on? In simple, those people who on them zakat is farz, for them is to give Qurbani. Those people who have no zakat, for them there is no Qurbani. And I don't think in this country, that I don't think, very less chance that there is people who on them Qurbani is not farz. If you don't have gold, which is equivalent that makes you sahib nisab, and silver that is equivalent that makes you the sahib nisab, even in cash, if you have that amount of money that becomes equivalent of the nisab, then even though you have to give Qurbani.